Right, friends, welcome back to 23rd week lecture part. We are going to discuss various events of the week from 1st June to 7th June. Let us look at the highlights. When it comes to highlights, the President of India's visit to Scandinavian country Sweden as well as Belarus, the Prime Minister's visit to Bangladesh, during the visit, the ratification of historic land boundary agreement between India and Bangladesh, prestigious award given to the former Prime Minister Atal Bihari Vajpayee, which was received by Narendra Modi, the Prime Minister of the country. When it comes to the other events, defense framework agreement was signed between India and United States of America, and IMD predicts deficient rainfall. It puts the rainfall figures at 88%. Previously, it told the rainfall will be around 93% of normal, but now it says 88%. When it comes to economy events, 25 basis points reduction in the repo rate as announced by the RBI Governor Raghuram Rajan. Maggi noodles controversy. When it comes to the sports events, French Open, Serena Williams as well as Wawrinka wins the titles, and as the president of FIFA, Sepp Blatter resigned. So these are the important events. Let us look at these events one by one. First and the foremost is the President of India's visit to Sweden and Belarus. President is the constitutional head of the country. He visited two nations, Sweden. Sweden is the Scandinavian nation. You may ask a question, what is a Scandinavian nation? Scandinavian nations are three. These three are called Scandinavian nations because of their ethnic and cultural similarities. Why these three countries are called Scandinavian nations? Because of their ethnic and cultural similarities. President of the country visited Sweden, and don't forget the Prime Minister of Sweden is Stefan Löfven is the Prime Minister of Sweden. The population of Sweden is approximately 10 million. That means around 1 crore population. And please don't forget, Arctic Circle passes through Sweden. Sweden is in the northern hemisphere, and Arctic Circle passes through Sweden, and some parts of it have severe cold weather. And the president of the country, when he visited Sweden, there was a bilateral agreement on sustainable urban development was signed. Bilateral agreement on sustainable urban development was signed, and at the same time, President delivered a lecture, and the topic was Tagore and Gandhi. Do they have contemporary relevance for global peace? Tagore and Gandhi, do they have contemporary relevance for global peace? That is the topic, and the President addressed in Sweden. Right, friends, after Sweden, the president of the country visited Belarus. Belarus is an East European country with the boundaries Lithuania, Latvia towards northern side. Western side, the boundary is Poland, and one side it is Russia. The population is around 1 crore or 10 million. Alexander Lukashenko is the president of this country. And the president was given ceremonial welcome at Majestic Palace of Independence, and at the same time, president also paid floral tributes at the Victory Monument, and the president of the country unveiled a bust of the Mahatma Gandhi in the Belarusian State University. In the Belarusian State University, the president of the country unveiled a bust of Mahatma Gandhi, and the Belarusian State University honored the president with the honorary degree. So these are the important aspects of the visit of the president of the country to Sweden as well as Belarus. Sweden is the Scandinavian country and Belarus is situated in the East European region, right? So let us look into the important event of the week, that is the visit of the Prime Minister of the country to Bangladesh. The Prime Minister visited Bangladesh and he spent 2 days. And before going into the details, let us have a glance at Bangladesh. Bangladesh got its independence in the year 1971. Prior to 1971, Bangladesh was a part of Pakistan. And when you go into the history, in the year 1905, Lord Curzon divided Bengal into two parts, East Bengal and West Bengal. Bengal was divided on religious lines in the year 1905 by Lord Curzon. But the cultural similarities are there between West Bengal and East Bengal. And East Bengal is predominantly inhabited by Muslim population and West Bengal is predominantly inhabited by Hindu population. And subsequently, during the partition of the country in the year 1947, East Bengal became part of Pakistan. East Bengal became part of Pakistan because the country was divided on religious lines. But if you look at the cultural similarities, the similarity as far as culture is concerned is almost same between the West Bengal as well as Bangladesh. And the population of Bangladesh is around 16 crores. Please don't forget, the population of Pakistan is around 18 crores. The population of Bangladesh is around 16 crores. Almost 90% of them are Muslims. And if you look at the map of Bangladesh, it has got three major rivers. One is the Jamuna. The river Jamuna, please don't forget, it is Brahmaputra. We call in India Brahmaputra. Brahmaputra becomes Jamuna when it enters Bangladesh. Similarly, Ganges or Ganga, the river becomes Padma when it enters Bangladesh. Another river is the Meghna. Jamuna, Padma, Meghna, these three together forms one of the biggest deltas in the world. Right? And most of the area of Bangladesh is flood prone. And India and Bangladesh together has the world's largest mangrove forest, and which is also housing Royal Bengal Tiger. So the world's largest mangrove forest. What is meant by mangrove forest? Mangrove forest is the forest which is raised in the saline soil. That is mangrove forest. And the world famous Sundarbans mangrove forest, 60% is situated in Bangladesh and 40% is situated in India. And this is broadly about Bangladesh. And many people may not know the official language of Bangladesh is Bengali. This shows the cultural similarity between Bangladesh and West Bengal state of India. Right? So this is about Bangladesh. The Prime Minister of Bangladesh is Sheikh Hasina. Party is Awami League. Bangladesh got its independence in the year 1971. In the year 1970, there was a massive cyclone in Bangladesh. Several people lost their lives. At that time, Bangladesh, which was known as East Pakistan, felt that it was neglected by West Pakistan, and India supported the independence movement of Bangladesh during the year 1971, and Bangladesh declared its independence in the year 1971. With the support of Indian government, Bangladesh declared its independence in the year 1971. And the present Prime Minister, Sheikh Hasina, is the daughter of the founding father of Bangladesh, Sheikh Mujibur Rahman. Please don't forget. And subsequently, Sheikh Mujibur Rahman, who was the founding father of Bangladesh, was assassinated in the year 1975 on August 15th. He, along with several family members, were assassinated by a coup in the military, and at the time, Sheikh Hasina was abroad. Right? Look into the important aspect of the Prime Minister's visit. First and the foremost is a historical land boundary agreement that was ratified. Instruments of ratification were exchanged between Indian and Bangladeshi authorities. We have discussed in detail in the previous lectures what is meant by land boundary agreement. Land boundary agreement is nothing but exchanging enclaves between India and Bangladesh. 111 enclaves will be transferred from India to Bangladesh, and 51 enclaves will be transferred from Bangladesh to India, and this solves the long-standing problem of boundary dispute between India and Bangladesh. So finally, the instruments of ratification were exchanged in the presence of both the prime ministers of the country. This is the biggest achievement of the Prime Minister Narendra Modi's visit. Right? The second important point is Bangladesh will open a mission in Guwahati. Similarly, India will open its missions in Khulna and Sylhet. Two special economic zones will be developed by India in Bangladesh. Another important aspect is the Prime Minister of the country paid homage to martyrs at the National Memorial and visited Bangabandhu Memorial Museum. The Prime Minister of the country paid homage to the martyrs at the National Memorial and visited Bangabandhu Memorial Museum. And at the same time, please don't forget, Sri Narendra Modi presented the Prime Minister of Bangladesh, Sheikh Hasina, a tapestry from Venkatagiri in Andhra Pradesh, hand-woven cloth. You may ask, what is a tapestry? Please look into this picture. Tapestry means a wall hanging made of cloth. And this fine art on cloth was woven by the persons from Venkatagiri, famous in Andhra Pradesh, and this hand-woven fabric in the form of wall hanging, which is called a tapestry, was given as a gift by the Prime Minister to Bangladeshi Prime Minister. Right? And look into the other aspects of this visit. 22 agreements as well as MOUs were signed. 22 agreements as well as MOUs were signed, and at the same time, Adani Group and the Reliance Group committed investments in Bangladesh. The other important aspect is that $2 billion line of credit was extended by the Prime Minister to Bangladesh. $2 billion line of credit. Two bus services were inaugurated. These two bus services facilitate the transport of passengers. If you look into the northeastern states, if they travel through Bangladesh, distance will be very short. If they have to travel only through India, then it is too longer to reach places like Agartala or Shillong. That's why two bus services were introduced. The first one is Dhaka-Shillong-Guwahati. The second one is Kolkata-Dhaka-Agartala. If persons travel from Kolkata to Agartala via Dhaka, it will be the shortest route. The other important aspect is the Prime Minister stated that these bus services are not only connecting lands but also binding hearts. The comment given by the Prime Minister is, these two bus services not only connect the lands but also bind hearts. Right friends, look into the next aspect of the Prime Minister's visit. The other important aspect is, on second day of the visit, the Prime Minister of the country received Bangladesh Liberation War Award to the former Prime Minister Atal Bihari Vajpayee. The former Prime Minister Atal Bihari Vajpayee is not in a position to go and receive the award because his health is not permitting to go to Bangladesh. And as such, the Prime Minister of the country, Narendra Modi, received Bangladesh Liberation War Award on behalf of Sri Atal Bihari Vajpayee, and the award was presented by the Bangladeshi President Abdul Hamid. And you may ask, why Atal Bihari Vajpayee was presented this award? When the Bangladesh war or liberation of Bangladesh took place, I have already told you, Indian government supported the liberation of Bangladesh in the year 1971. At that time, the former Prime Minister Atal Bihari Vajpayee was the president of Bharatiya Janasangh. He was also a member of parliament at that time. As a president of Bharatiya Janasangh, he supported the cause of Bangladeshi people, and in recognition of his support as the president of Bharatiya Janasangh, in the year 1971, he was awarded Bangladesh Liberation War Award, and this is received by the Prime Minister of the country, Narendra Modi. And looking into the other aspects, the Prime Minister called on the President of Bangladesh, Mohammed Abdul Hamid. The second point is, Prime Minister visited Dhakeshwari Temple, Kali Temple in Dhaka, also visited Ramakrishna Mission at Gopibagh. Right? So these are the important aspects of the visit of the Prime Minister. And look into the other aspects. Several important issues were discussed during the visit. One such important issue is, Indian Prime Minister agreed to consider Bangladesh proposal for second Maitri Express between Kolkata and Khulna. The second important point is cooperation in railways to open Akura-Agartala railway link also. Article exchanged was a memento depicting the helm of INS Vikrant. At the same time, audio recording of historic speech of Sheikh Mujibur Rahman on February 6, 1972 at Kolkata. Right, look into the last one. I would like to see how the visit resulted into. The end result of the visit is, first and the foremost is ratification of the land boundary agreement. This agreement, all of you are well aware, it was signed by the then Prime Minister of the country, Indira Gandhi, as well as the Prime Minister of Bangladesh, Sheikh Mujibur Rahman, in the year 1974. So, it got ratified after 41 years, and this is the biggest achievement. Second thing is, more emphasis on 1971 war. More emphasis on 1971 war. This is clearly evident because to liberate Bangladesh, India at the time cooperated. Not only that, Bharatiya Janasangh fully supported the cause of Bangladeshis. So, the second important point which emanated from the visit is, India and Bangladesh are culturally not different. We are saath-saath. Right? So, that is the message tried to be given by the Prime Minister after this visit. The third point is access to northeastern states through Bangladesh. Through Bangladesh, access to northeastern states is quite easy, and it is a shorter distance, shorter journey time, and because of the flagging off of two buses, it is clearly evident that in future, several buses may be introduced to access northeastern states. The fourth important point is inland navigation. Bangladesh is crisscrossed by several rivers. If inland navigation is improved, then what will happen? The freight can reach. Freight means goods can reach northeastern states with less expenditure. So these are the four points which emanated out of the visit of the Indian Prime Minister to Bangladesh, but there are two shortcomings. First and the foremost is the Teesta River waters dispute. There is Teesta River which originates in Sikkim and passes through West Bengal and flows into Bangladesh. There is no mention of Teesta River water dispute which is hanging on for several years. Second important point is no concrete action plan to stop infiltration across the border. India-Bangladesh border is more than 4,000 kilometers and it is densely populated on both the sides. Lot of infiltration takes place. Several people are losing their lives because of the firing by border security force authorities. In the world, India-Bangladesh border is one of the four places where infiltration of people takes place across the border and several people are losing their lives. And this is the second issue where there is no concrete action plan was devised during the visit. So, four important events which came out of this visit of the Prime Minister and two shortcomings. Let us hope these two, Teesta River waters as well as concrete action plan to prevent infiltration will be solved in due course of time. Okay friends, let us look at the next issue. 20 army personnel killed in militant attack in Manipur. Manipur is bordering Myanmar. These infiltrators, they have their bases in Myanmar and from there they attacked army personnel. The army personnel are on road opening patrol duty and when they were going, these insurgents attacked them and 20 army personnel belonging to 6 Dogra regiment were killed. Very unfortunate event. And subsequently, army destroyed the insurgent camps based in Myanmar, and this issue we will discuss in 24th week. Look into the next issue. India, United States of America signed a 10-year defense framework agreement. Their Secretary of Defense, Dr. Ashton Carter, as well as our Defense Minister, Manohar Parikar, exchanged the documents pertaining to the treaty, and the treaty is a 10-year defense framework agreement which facilitates co-development and manufacture of defense equipment and technology. And please don't forget, we are importing almost 70% of our defense equipment, and this defense cooperation agreement with USA assumed significance in view of the fact most of our defense imports are from Russia. Right? Look into the next issue. IMD, Indian Meteorological Department, predicts 88% rainfall. Indian Meteorological Department forecasts 88% of the rainfall. I have already told you in the last classes, previously it predicted 93% of average. Average, they take 50 years of average. That is 89 centimeters of rainfall. Out of this 89 centimeters of rainfall, the rainfall in the southwest monsoon season, please don't forget, India gets rainfall because of two monsoon seasons. Southwest monsoon, around 70-80% of rainfall is because of southwest monsoon, and the balance is because of northeast monsoon. And this year, southwest monsoon, we are going to get 88% of rainfall if the prediction of IMD is true. And when the rainfall is between 90% to 96%, it is below normal. 90% to 96% it is below normal, and when the rainfall is below 90%, it is deficient. So now IMD prediction is rainfall will be deficient this year. Right friends? Look into the economy events, RBI's monetary policy. Monetary policy, RBI, once in 2 months, that means in the year, 6 times, RBI sits together to decide monetary policy. And during the monetary policy of first week of June, that means this is the second monetary policy for the financial year 2015-16. In this monetary policy, repo rate was reduced by 25 basis points or 0.25%. And in the banking parlance, please don't forget, 1% is 100 basis points. 1% is 100 basis points, that means 1 basis point is 0.01%. Repo rate was reduced by 25 basis points. That means at present repo rate stands at 7.25%. We have discussed several times the repo rate is the short-term interest rate. Short-term interest rate when banks borrow money from RBI for day-to-day liquidity requirements. So it gives a signal to the market how the interest rate structure will be in the country. Repo rate basically gives a signal to the market outside. So now the repo rate is 7.25%. During the past 6 months, RBI reduced 0.75%. Repo rate came down from 8% to 7.25%. So 0.75% was reduced during the past 6 months. And now banks are reducing their base rates one by one. Right, friends, look into the next one. Foreign remittances limit raised to $2,50,000 per year. $2,50,000 per year. Foreign remittances. If you are the resident Indian means you are required to stay in this country during the year for at least 6 months. Then you are resident Indian. You are required to stay at least 6 months in the country, 182 days, more than 182 days. If you are staying in the country for more than 182 days, you are considered as resident Indian. So many other stipulations are there. I am not going into detail these stipulations, but if you are resident Indian, then you can deposit or you can invest in foreign land not more than $2,50,000 per year. You can invest in foreign land not more than $2,50,000 in a year as per the recent instructions of RBI. And medical treatment and education, that is separate, that will not be included in the limit of $2,50,000 per annum. Right, friends? Look into the sports subletter. Resigned as president of FIFA. We have discussed last week a corruption scandal in FIFA. Sepp Blatter is the president since 1998. He belongs to Switzerland. He won 5 times. Recently, he got elected 5th time. But several of his colleagues, including his vice president, are being investigated by US and Swiss authorities on corruption scandal. And in view of the corruption scandal, Sepp Blatter finally resigned after 17 years at the helm of affairs. Then Indonesia's Super Series premier in Jakarta, Parupalli Kashyap, famous badminton player from India, created history when he defeated world champion Chen Long of China in that tournament in the quarterfinals. In the quarterfinals, India's Parupalli Kashyap defeated Chen Long of China. Chen Long is the world's number one ranked player. Parupalli Kashyap defeated Chen Long in quarterfinals, but he lost in the semifinals. Parupalli Kashyap lost to Kento Momota of Japan in the semifinals. Look into the next one, French Open Tennis Championship. Stan Wawrinka of Switzerland created history by defeating world's number one Novak Djokovic. World's number one Novak Djokovic lost in the final to Stan Wawrinka of Switzerland. Stan Wawrinka, 30-year-old, is the oldest to win French Open in 25 years. Previously, his victory was Australian Open. And when it comes to women's singles, it is Serena Williams got her 20th title. Serena Williams got her 20th Grand Slam title. You may ask, what is Grand Slam? Grand Slam is four tournaments put together is Grand Slam: Australian Open, French Open, Wimbledon, and US Open. These four put together is called Grand Slam tennis tournaments. And you may ask, who holds the record in the women's Grand Slam? That is none other than Margaret Court of Australia. Margaret Court of Australia holds the record of winning 24 Grand Slam tournaments till date, closely followed by Steffi Graf of Germany with 22 titles. And now Serena Williams of United States of America has got 20 Grand Slam titles with the victory of French Open. Let us hope Serena Williams to cross the 24 Grand Slam title record created by Margaret Court of Australia. Right, friends? When it comes to the miscellaneous events, most important event is Maggie Noodles. During the past 10-15 days, Maggie Noodles is in the news. How it came into the news? Before that, what is Nestle? Nestle is the food and beverages company based in Vevey in Switzerland. It is started in the year 1905. In terms of revenue, it is the world's largest food and beverages company based in Switzerland. It has got its units across the world in several countries, and recently it is into the news because of instant Maggi noodles. How the issue started? The issue was started when Uttar Pradesh Food Safety and Drug Administration authorities, basically from Barabanki in Uttar Pradesh, Sri V.K. Pandey, they sent some samples for testing. In the samples, it was detected lead up to 17 parts per million. The allowed limit is 2.5 parts per million. But it was found 17 parts. That means around 6 to 7 times high. The second thing is, the label says there is no MSG. MSG means monosodium glutamate. MSG is monosodium glutamate. The label says there is no MSG, but there are traces of MSG found. Lead was found in more than the permissible quantities, and MSG traces were found. Subsequently, several states tested. Some states stated that they found excess quantities. Some states stated that they are within permissible limits. And under these circumstances, fingers were pointed against Amitabh Bachchan, Preeti Zinta, Madhuri Dixit, as they are the brand ambassadors for the past several years. Under these circumstances, the global CEO of Nestle came to the country, and finally, they stated that we apply same quality standards across the world and we felt unfounded reasons which resulted in confusion. Finally, they took out these brands from the shelf. That means they withdrew the product. And at the same time, FSSAI, which was established in the year 2006. This FSSAI was established in the year 2006. It also recalled this 9 approved variants of Maggi from the market. That means, on one side, FSSAI withdrew the Maggi noodles from the market, and at the same time, Nestle also withdrew from the market. And subsequently, Nestle approached Bombay High Court. Right, when it comes to the Government of India's Consumer Affairs Minister Ram Vilas Paswan says that on behalf of the consumers, under Consumer Protection Act 1986, on behalf of the customers under Consumer Protection Act 1986. The issue will be referred to Consumer Dispute Redressal Commission. The issue will be referred to National Consumer Dispute Redressal Commission or NCDRC. That means it may give compensation to the people affected because of the non-standard food products in the market. Let us look at this slide. Excess quantities of lead or presence of MSD, what it will do? Excess quantities of lead, because the permissible limit is 2.5 ppm, but excess quantity was found up to 15 to 20 ppm in the samples. That indicates that the effect will be more in the children, excess quantities of lead. And you may ask a question, how the lead pollution occurs? Basically, lead pollution occurs because of release from industries like paints, e-waste, lead acid batteries, ceramics, bangle industry. What will happen? These industries, untreated effluents will go into the river stream, and ultimately the river water will go into the soil and it will enter the food chain. That means it is a vicious cycle. That means because of untreated effluents coming from bangle industries, ceramics, lead acid batteries, e-waste, they are being straight away discharged into the rivers, and ultimately it is polluting soil and it is entering food chain. That is the reason why more lead is detected in the food samples, and here it affects the nervous system, brain and kidneys. More quantity or excess quantity of lead affects brain as well as nervous system, and it will also have effect on the kidneys. What is MSG? MSG is monosodium glutamate. Basically, it is the taste enhancer. It is the cheapest way of enhancing the flavors. And more quantities of MSG, some people say that it will cause headache and palpitations, and some people say that there are no harmful effects. Whatever the things, as the things stand today, there is a case for ensuring stricter standards when effluents from various industries are released into rivers, because they are the major causes for lead pollution in the food products. If people test food products of other companies or other samples, definitely they may come up with surprising results because of the reason lead is totally mixing into the water because of the industry effluents. Right, friends, look at the last event of the week. India is home to around 200 million undernourished children. As per the Food and Agricultural Organization report, FAO, what is FAO? FAO is United Nations Organization, established on October 16, 1945. Please don't forget, October 16 is celebrated as World Food Day. So as to commemorate the establishment of Food and Agricultural Organization, it is United Nations Organization. At present, the headquarters is in Rome in Italy. And as per its recent report, out of 4 children in the world, one lives in India. India is home to around 195 million, and during the past 25 years, we reduced only 15 million people. Right? With this, let us conclude the lecture part. Please do join for question and answer session. Have a nice day. Thank you.